Insights, where we discuss a new topic in every episode. This is your host Ananya Sharma. Today we are going to talk about Tulsi Gabbard and President Donald Trump and her chances against him in the upcoming presidential elections.
I have to say, Ananya, that at this stage it looks very unlikely that Tulsi is going to win the Democratic nomination to fight against Trump. If she wins the nomination, I believe she can definitely defeat Trump. If she doesn't win the nomination, there are good chances that Trump can win.
Rajesh, why do you say that?
Well, you know, American people are tired of endless wars. They send their soldiers to die on foreign battlefields without any high moral cause. And Trump, in fact, came into the presidency on an assurance that he would stop this. He said, I'm going to end the wars in Afghanistan, in Iraq, in the Middle East. But then he couldn't do it. He couldn't deliver. He broke up the Iran deal, which Obama had negotiated very successfully. And so people want a genuine anti-war candidate. And actually, at the moment, there are only two genuine anti-war candidates. There's Bernie Sanders and there's Tulsi Gabbard.
Okay, since Bernie and Tulsi both are anti-war, why do you think that Tulsi is the better candidate?
Bernie Sanders will have no chance against Trump. It'll be a knockout. But if Trump is pitted against Tulsi Gabbard, my own view is that Tulsi Gabbard will stand her ground. She will not, you know, be like Hillary, who got a bit rattled. Tulsi will stand her ground and she will clobber Trump. See, Bernie could not even defeat Hillary. He has come back to make a second try at the presidency. And Bernie is a very nice man, but he's an old war horse. If Bernie were to become president, theoretically, everybody would be having their eye on the vice president, thinking that, okay, you know, Bernie's so old, he could knock off any time, and the vice president is such an important person because he could become the future president. But with Tulsi, you have somebody young, smart, active, alert. It's a different ballgame. So between the two anti-war candidates, I think Tulsi is the one. The US presidency is, let's face it, a highly stressful job. You saw what happened to Obama. He came into the presidency, his head was all black. And when he went out of the presidency, it was all white, his face had changed. You could see the stress. You can see the stress even on Trump. I mean, Trump is, of course, much older, but his jowls are sagging. Already, the stress has been there through this first presidency. Forget the impeachment, forget everything else. That would have added to the stress. But the US president's job is a highly stressful job. You need a fit physical candidate to do that job. And Bernie has been having physical problems ever since he announced that he would run for president. So do the Americans want somebody who is, you know, going to take sick leave all the time, or so frequently when there could be a crisis in America, in the world? So with due respect to Bernie, I am no spring chicken myself. I think this is a match. The presidential election is a boxing match. And when you become president, it's also like a boxing match. Bernie in the ring with Trump, I don't see him giving any knockout blows. But Tulsi, she can match Trump argument for argument. She can outwit him. If they are both in the ring together, I believe Tulsi will deliver a knockout.
But you haven't explained why Tulsi will flatten Trump, to use a boxing analogy.
You know, Ananya, I know this is going to sound very strange, but a few months ago I went to the Himalayas. I was looking for a certain kind of mystic in the Himalayas, and I managed to meet him. And we had a discussion on spiritual matters. And then I asked him something out of curiosity, just to test him. I said, there is this US presidential election which is coming up, and there is a man called Trump. because I thought this is an old mystic and he may not be reading the papers. There's a man called Trump who is bidding for re-election, and there is a lady called Tulsi Gabbard. And if they were to come face to face, who do you think would win? And he thought for a while. And then he said something very, very strange, but also something very, very interesting.
Really? What did he say?
He said to me that some years ago, a man had come to him, a white man, not a man like me, and he had asked him a similar question about the US presidential election. But he had put it differently. He said, do you think that Barack Obama is going to win the US presidential election? At that time, people didn't even give Obama much of a chance.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yes. He said, he told this guy, Obama is going to win the election. But he said, there is one more thing that is going to happen. There is a powerful force that is going to emerge in the world. There's going to be another O. And that O is going to come, and Obama is going to smash that O. He said there would be actually, I think his words were, there will be another very similar sounding name, an enemy of free thinking people, and Obama will flatten this person.
Who?
Osama. Sounds very similar. Osama bin Laden. You see, Obama and Osama sound very similar. So this mystic said there is going to be a fight between two titans with a name beginning with O, you know. And this time he said that the T's can have a fight. And the only T's which I can see are Tulsi and Trump.
So who did he say will win?
He said Tulsi will win, but only if she's allowed to step into the ring. So Trump might still get defeated, but he felt that Tulsi had the best chances to defeat him.
But my question still is, why?
Well, you know, he was in the Himalayas. There are a lot of Ayurvedic medicinal plants, rare species which grow in the Himalayas. And one of the plants which grows there is a plant called Tulsi. Tulsi, according to indigenous Ayurvedic medical literature, is one of the greatest medicinal plants in the world. So this mystic said that America right now is in great need of medicine. And Tulsi represents that medicine that America needs to be on the right track for itself and for the world once again.
All right, but that may be the mystic's point of view, Rajesh. What about your view?
I agree with the mystic, Ananya. Of course, my reasoning is different, what you would call more educated reasoning. Sometimes people can come to the same conclusion by following different arguments. So I would not dismiss the mystic's argument, even if my logical mind cannot accept it.
But what are the reasons that you think that the American people will choose Tulsi over Trump?
For many reasons. I'll give you 5 reasons out of the top of my head.
All right, I'm listening.
Tulsi is a beautiful woman. She has beauty, brains, and a great personality. In an ideal world, this should not matter, but sometimes these things do matter. Beauty has power of its own kind, and that power is multiplied when it's combined with brains and mature thinking. So I think one very good reason.
Okay, and reason number 2?
Tulsi is articulate and confident in a way in which Trump is perhaps not. Mr. Trump is actually not a very confident character. I will tell you why. People who are genuinely confident, they don't boast very often. Mr. Trump keeps boasting, I'm the best, I'm the greatest, I have done this, I have done that. You know, it's part of the American style in a way. Genuinely confident people, they are not so boastful in my experience. They are more measured. They don't have to boast. They don't need to convince anybody. Their work speaks for itself. And I think Tulsi's character is that of a person who has more genuine confidence than Trump. Trump has his power, he has his billions, he's the sitting president. But Tulsi has a different kind of power. I spoke about beauty, brains, confidence, articulation. These are the reasons. One and two.
Very interesting. Reason number three?
Tulsi is speaking from the heart and she's also speaking the truth. You know, when Hillary contested against Trump, Trump used a term against Hillary. He called her crooked Hillary. And I won't go into the merits of the accusation, but I will speak a bit about the public reaction. The public reaction was, you know, the guy's right. She's not straight. She is a bit crooked. But I will tell you 100%, Trump will not be able to make those allegations against Tulsi. Because if he does, people are going to nod their heads once again. And they are going to say, you know what? There is somebody crooked in the room, but it sure ain't Tulsi.
All right. What about reason number four?
Reason number four is courage. Tulsi is a woman of courage. This is demonstrated by many facts. She was a soldier in the Iraq war. Despite being a soldier, she had the wisdom to become anti-war. She saw the futility of war. She was a Hindu. She practiced her faith. She said the Gita helped her during her difficult times in Iraq. She knew that if she said, oh, I'm a Christian, I don't believe in Hinduism, she could have got the Christian vote. I mean, she will still get the Christian vote, but she could have got the prejudiced Christian vote. You know, people who say that American president has to be a Christian. And but she is courageous. She didn't care. She said, I believe in Christianity, I believe in Hinduism. Lord Krishna says, there's no, you know, these things are not irreconcilable. Lord Krishna says, people who worship other gods, they also worship me. So Tulsi can believe in Jesus and she can believe in Krishna at the same time. And but she's demonstrated great courage. I think the world is looking for such a courageous head of state and the most powerful country in the world. I won't say that Trump doesn't have courage. He also has a kind of courage. But Trump is quite often unnecessarily combative. You know, he is a, you can say almost that his default position is combat. It's good to be combative, but when it's only when it's needed. One shouldn't be unnecessarily combative.
Excuse me for interrupting, Rajesh, but people do say that Tulsi is isolationist.
That's the pro-war lobby speaking, Ananya. Supposing I'm living in a neighborhood and the US is living in a community of nations, more than 150 nations. I'm living in this neighborhood and I keep getting embroiled in disputes between my neighbors. My neighbors are fighting, I go there, I take somebody's side. I'm not a peacemaker, but I take positions. I support somebody and I'm anti somebody else. These are not moral reasons why I'm getting involved in these wars. I'm getting involved in these wars because of pressure from various lobbies. There is the arms lobby, there is the military lobby, there is the hawkish lobby, there's the oil lobby. These kind of things are making America isolated in the world. So what is isolationism? If America is isolated, if I'm living in a neighborhood and everybody says, oh, this guy is just a bully, you know, he just beats his stick around, he doesn't have much sense. That is making me isolated in the community of nations. America is getting isolated. It's not involved in the battle against the environment. It's not involved in noble causes, which it used to be in before. So I would argue that actually America has been pursuing isolationism for many years. Isolationism is not about getting involved when you don't need to get involved. I'm saying America can get involved in wars, but only after close scrutiny, once they see that this is a real moral issue. We need to get involved. People need us. Then that's different.
And what about the fifth reason?
The fifth reason is, I think, Tulsi has shown courage not only with regard to overseas American policy, but she's also taken a firm stance against regulating arms sale within the United States. I think people need to, you know, consider that it's time to review. It's all good to say the right to carry arms, but the right to carry arms doesn't mean that I can buy machine guns and I can shoot 100 people in a mall. The right to carry arms does not mean, where has this happened that people have used a machine gun to protect themselves in the US? You can protect yourself by using an ordinary gun against somebody who tries to rob you, somebody who tries to assault your women. But you don't need a weapon which is going to fire a few hundred bullets in a few minutes. What is the need for this kind of weapons? So Tulsi has spoken out very strongly that there should be regulation of, there should be gun control of a kind. Okay, guns can still be sold, but not the way they are currently sold. I went to the US some years ago and I had a toothache and I went to buy some medicine and they said, no, they can't give me medicine until I have a doctor's prescription. It was an ordinary antibiotic, which I had been taking for many years every time I had a problem. But they refused to sell me an antibiotic because I didn't have a prescription. That's a good thing. But I was told, if you go into a shop and you say, I want to buy a few guns, they'll say, well, feel free. No need for ID. No need for prescription. But that tablet, that's just going to cure my tooth. And I am, in a sense, responsible for myself. But if I buy these heavy-duty guns and I go into a mall and start shooting people just because I feel like it, that's not healthy for any society. So I think Tulsi has taken a strong stand. Maybe the stand could have been yet stronger, but let's not try and fight all the battles at the same time. I think this must have been a thought. She's very clear-headed. And I believe, like the mystic in the Himalayas said, the world is a very strange place. He was right about Osama having to battle a man with a name very similar to him. And he may be right that this time the two titans who are going to fight the battle are going to have names beginning with T. If Tulsi gets into the ring, I'm betting on her.
So that was it for today. Thank you, Rajesh, for being here with us and sharing your views and opinions on something this big. I'm pretty sure people will be influenced and they will make the right decision.
Thank you, Ananya. It's always good to be with you and your team. And I look forward to more episodes with you. I'm sure this episode will be watched with great interest, even by people who may not have so much close interest in the American election.
Thank you so much for being here with us yet again. We will see you with another episode very soon.